Hey Product Hunt, Jiří here, CEO and founder of Supernova, and in this short video I would like to show you what Supernova is all about. Now Supernova helps you build, maintain and manage design systems in much smarter ways than what is possible today. And I think what better way to show you than just go and create one design system from scratch so you can see the power of Supernova for yourself. Now it will only really take me a few minutes, so sit back and enjoy. Now for this design system speedrun, let's start with just bringing some data in so we have something to play around with. As you can see, I am inside Supernova, but everything is now empty. I just have the design system, so I will go into my Figma. And as you can see here, I have two files. In one file, I have all the style guides, all the icons and so on. And in another, I have all my components. There is a lot of components. It's just a design system file that we are using internally for a Supernova design system. So what I will do, I will just simply share the link. I've already logged in with Figma inside Supernova, so I can go back to Supernova, link a Figma file, copy paste that, and now all my data will be imported. Once this is imported, I can go to Figma again and grab the second file. So I'll do that, go Cloud Components, share the link, and copy paste to Figma, link a new file, and now we will download all the components from the second file, which will basically create a design system that consists of all the information from the two files inside Figma. This has finished importing as well, and as you can see, we have quite a lot of components now added, so let's just check the design system that we have everything. Let's go first to the tokens, and as you can see, we have brought all the styles from the Figma, including colors, including typographies and so on, and we will use them inside the documentation in a moment. We've also brought all the components, so some of the icons, some buttons, some inputs and so on, everything that was included in those files. And finally, some assets, some icons and so on. So now we have all the data inside our design system from the design side. We'll enhance them with the code inside the documentation. But first, let's just create some of the documentation. To start with the documentation, I will switch to the documentation editor. And as you can see, I've already started with the content. I have created a introductory page, really, added some nice backgrounds, also added this nice mascot of our design system, which already improved the quality by like 1000%. Now I would like to start using the elements from the Figma that I have imported inside the documentation. So I'll switch to style guide, and specifically I'm interested in colors. As you can see, I've created some of the guidelines and I would like to highlight my background and foreground colors. To do that, I can use I can use this in Notion, a command line basically. So I will write /token. It will give me a list of blocks that I can use inside the documentation. And we have blocks for every occasion, really, for every type of the design system element. I'm interested in listing tokens, so I will use token list, and I will select the category of tokens. I will filter by the primary group that contains those tokens, and I will select the primary background token, and also, again, primary color. Now, as you can see, I've added two tokens, and the nice thing is that every time those tokens change, it will actually propagate into the documentation as well, so you don't have to change it manually or keep track where you are actually using those tokens. Same thing works for components and same thing works for the assets as well. Now let's continue. Let's add typography. So the very same thing. I'll just write token, but this time I will use token group, basically a group of certain elements. I want to list all the typography tokens. So now I have all typography tokens, including their weights and so on. Finally, I want to add my icons, the icon library that I've brought, just so I have some reference guide where people can see all the icons that they can be using. I will write asset this time, and this allows me to tap into the asset library that I have inside Supernova. You can see that I have the icons, I'll spawn those, I'll confirm, and now we have the asset library here as well. Maybe do a small modification so it looks nicer. Now to properly document a button, we need two parts of the documentation. We need the designer side and we also need the code side, and we will do both of them. So let's start with the designer side. As you can see, I've already written an overview of this button, which basically represents a structure of the button and how you should be using it and so on. But what I would like to highlight are some variants of the button coming from Figma that our designers can be using in their day-to-day work. So I will just write a Figma because it comes from Figma as a source, and I can actually tap into any Figma frame and bring this into the documentation. This frame is live, so if you change any of the variants of the button, it will actually propagate into documentation as well. So let's just add a frame. You can see that I have all the components here available to me, and I have a lot of variants. Yeah, we do use a lot of buttons inside Supernova. So I will maybe just use the last four. Hopefully they will look nice. And indeed, I think they do look nice, so this is acceptable to me. You can also see that I've added some interactive Figma files, so we can play around with the components inside Figma or open the file if we need to. Finally, I would like to document the code part of the button, so let's switch to the code tab. As you can see, I've added some of the basic descriptions already. I've added the code that represents the base usage of the button. I also added storybook story. So if you are using storybook or chromatic, you can just drop the story into the Supernova and we will render this properly. And finally, I would like to show some real example of my real code coming from a real code base. So what I will do, I use a React block, and this block allows me to render live code from the React components. Now you can see that it spawns some example, and this is indeed a React code, React component, but I would like to use my own code base, so I just copy paste the code that I have prepared. And as you can see, as an dependency, I'm using Material UI, and it did render the Material UI components. So if you would like to use something a little bit more advanced and create something beyond the stories, for example, or if you are not using the storybook, you can simply put this into the documentation as well. And because this is live, you can actually experiment with it however you want to. Let's publish the documentation, see what we have created. Now with the documentation published, I can just go and view the documentation, and we have our main page, which we have created with our beautiful cat. We also have the style guide with the colors that we have selected. We also have the icons, which we have all rendered and selected coming from Figma or any other source. And we also have our component, our button, well documented. We have all the variants that we have selected that should show here. We have some Figma interactive files, and we also have the code representation, the code that we have added as an example, the storybook implementation, and also finally the real showcase coming from the Material UI codebase being fully interactive. Now this, I think, makes it very compelling to use the documentation inside Supernova, but it is not all, and I want to show you one last thing. You see, we have built Supernova so it helps designers and developers with the handoff as well. And we have created this automation pipeline that allows you to take any kind of design system data and convert it into something that you are actually using in your production code bases. Now you basically just built a procedure, we call it exporter, and this procedure defines what should be the output of your design system. And I will show you one such procedure so you understand what it is about. Now, as you can see, we have a store here, and it's basically a procedure that the community has already built. And what I would like to do is to deliver my CSS definitions, my CSS tokens and styles into a repository that I have created before recording this video. So what I will do, I will go to the CSS exporter. You can see that I have already installed this. I will go to the builds, and I will basically invoke this exporter against my design system. So it creates the design system representation of the tokens or code representation of the tokens as a CSS. So I will click new, and I will select a default brand. And then I just have to select a target for the or the destination for the code which will be generated. Now we can generate code in any form or shape as long as you can define it through a transformation inside or in JavaScript. And you can also use the same for components, for the assets, and also for the documentation. So you can actually create a really sophisticated pipeline transferring data from your design or code sources to anything else, but really using the design system as a centerpiece of this pipeline. Now I want to deliver everything as a pull request, so I'm opening a pull request. I've already logged in with my organization. I want to use my product hunt project, and I want to use my main branch, which was detected. I think putting stuff into slash tokens is also fine. So I'll run this exporter and just wait a few seconds before it generates the appropriate code. Now, as you can see, it only really takes a few seconds. So it has been published, and now I can view the PR that was opened against my repository. As you can see, this repository has now one PR, the first PR, and it has some new tokens and styles based on the data from the Racket design system. And indeed, if we go to files changed, you can see that we have generated borders, colors, and so on. Now you can completely change this procedure and you can generate the code in any form or shape that you want to for any technology, even for multiple technologies at the same time. So if you have different repositories, different code bases, and so on, you can do all of this for all your design system data. Now, this was the last thing that I wanted to show you. It is already far too long, but I hope that you enjoyed. Everything else you have to explore, but we have quite a lot of resources that can help you start it. I hope that you enjoyed the video and have a good one.